As we congregate here in this holy sanctuary today for the speech and award ceremony of Naparima Girls High School, we bring to mind what Scripture tells us, and Scripture tells us that this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it right where you are. Let me invite you to just close your eyes and bow your heads in prayer. Gracious and wonderful Savior, as we gather together today, O Lord, as a school, Naparima Girls High School, as we come together, O Lord, for our speech day and awards ceremony, we pray, O Lord, your Holy Spirit's blessings upon us. We celebrate this day. This day, O Lord, where the students of this school would be rewarded for their hard work. We celebrate this day, O Lord, and your divine majesty. And we pray, O Father, that you would pour out upon us the gift of your Holy Spirit, that as we worship you today, and today, O Lord, as we recognize those who would be awarded, we pray your blessing upon this place. And we ask, O Lord, that all that would be said and done will be truly be done for your honor and your glory. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Thank you all for taking your seat.
Dr. The Honorable Mia Gatsby-Dolly, Minister of Education and Member of Parliament for St. Anne's East, the Honorable Faris Al-Rawi, Minister of Rural Development and Local Government and Member of Parliament for San Fernando West, the moderator of the Synod of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago, the Right Reverend Daniel Chance, the Honorable Brian Manning, Minister in the Ministry of Finance and Member of Parliament for San Fernando East, Chief Education Officer Dr. Peter Smith, Deputy Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Education Mr. Wilson Henderson, School Supervisor 3 Mr. Sheldon Joda, School Chaplain Reverend Litra Jacob, and all other members of the clergy, Chairman of the Naparima Girls High School Administrative Committee, Mrs. Indra Devi Singh, President of the Naparima Girls High School Alumni Association, Mrs. Beverly Mohan, Acting Principal of Naparima Girls High School, Mrs. Karen Bali, Acting Vice Principal of Naparima Girls High School, Mrs. Naomi Adonis Woodsley, other specially invited guests, parents, members of staff, and students, good morning. I am Micaiah Hackshaw, head girl of Naparima Girls High School.
And I am Scarlett Ramarain, deputy head girl. And today, we are extremely honored to be your chairpersons for this morning's program. On this day, we celebrate the remarkable achievements of our members of the student body at Naparima Girls High School. Our students are no strangers to academic and non-academic excellence, embodying our vision to emerge as all-rounded individuals.
Whilst we recognize individual achievements, we must not forget the collective efforts that facilitate these successes. Firstly, we give thanks to God, for with whom all things are possible. We also thank our cheerleaders, our principal and vice principal, teachers, members of ancillary staff, parents, and friends, all of whom provide unwavering support. Most importantly, we would like to express our deepest gratitude and congratulations to all the awardees here today for their hard work and commitment to excellence. Naparima Girls High School is like a well-oiled machine, continuously churning as both teachers and students are constantly engaged in extra and co-curricular activities throughout the academic year under the guidance and leadership of our administration. Mrs. Bali's unwavering dedication to leadership and commitment to upholding the standards of Naparima Girls High School has resulted in numerous successes. We all admire her as she leads with firmness, kindness, and humility. Please welcome our principal, Mrs. Karen Bali, to deliver the principal's report for the academic year of 2023 to 2024.
Dreams can become a reality when we possess a vision, a plan, and the courage to chase after it relentlessly. The words of Walt Disney. Over 112 years ago, the Canadian missionaries, who were around long before Walt Disney, would have possessed a vision, made a plan, and were courageous enough to pursue it relentlessly. This resulted in the birth of our very own school, Naparima Girls High School, which has become a premier institution and school of choice in South Trinidad. Dr. The Honorable Nian Gaspidoli, Minister of Education and Member of Parliament for St. Anne's East, the Honorable Faris Al-Rawi, Minister of Rural Development and Local Government and Minister of Parliament for San Fernando West, the Honorable Brian Manning, Minister in the Ministry of Finance and Member of Parliament for San Fernando East, the moderator of the Synod of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago, the Right Reverend Daniel Chance, Chief Education Officer, Dr. Peter Smith, Deputy Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Education, Mr. William Henderson, School Supervisor 3, Mr. Sheldon Joda, School Chaplain, Reverend Litra Jacob, and all other members of the clergy, Chairman of the Presbyterian Secondary Schools Board of Education, Mr. Roy Umrau, School Manager, Mr. Kenny Arjun, Chairman of the Naparima Girls High School Administrative Committee, Mrs. Indra Devi Singh, President of the Naparima Girls High School Alumni Association, Mrs. Beverly Mohan, Acting Vice Principal of Naparima Girls High School, Mrs. Naomi Adonis Woodsley, other specially invited guests, parents, members of staff, students, good morning and welcome to our Speech Day and Award Ceremony for the year 2023-2024. This day is set aside to honor and celebrate our graduates who have excelled in the CSEC and CAPE examinations. We also celebrate all of our other students who have excelled in academics as well as extra and co-curricular activities over the last year. All those students who would have possessed a vision, a plan, and the courage to chase after it relentlessly. It is my privilege now to share a glimpse of the activities and achievements over the last academic year. The achievements and activities pages of your program will provide information on the number of activities which our students participated and excelled. This alone should reiterate the fact that Naparima Girls is all about the holistic development of our students. Of special note is the fact that our girls excelled in international competitions, and some of them even belong to national teams. We congratulate Priyanka Kilawan, table tennis, Aradhana Ramnarayan Singh, chess, Samia Karim, Isabel Waller, and Kaylee Rajkumar, badminton. These girls have represented our country exceedingly well. Mention must also be made of our choirs and individuals who excelled at the 35th Biennial Music Festival, bringing home 6 of the championship trophies. I am sure we all remember chuckling at the caption in the news, "What does it take to beat a Naps Girls Choir?" Another Naps Girls Choir. Naparima Girls High School also holds the distinct honor of the first school to score a hat-trick in the African History Quiz, placing first in the competition in 3 consecutive years, 2021, 2022, and 2023. I think all of this deserves a round of applause. Congratulations to all of our students who continue to participate in competitions, and to the teachers who encourage their participation and who work with them to ensure that their contributions are of a high standard. Our teachers also try to provide wide and varied opportunities for learning to take place outside of the classroom. This is achieved by the numerous field trips that our students are taken on, not limited only to Trinidad. This year, 2 groups of students were afforded the opportunity to go on a foreign field trip to Montreal, Canada, bringing to life their learnings in the French classrooms. Some of our students have even used their own initiative and found opportunities outside of Trinidad and Tobago. 2 students participated in the AFS Global STEM Academics Program. This saw Rhea Mohammed spending a month in Egypt and Ambika Prasad spending a month in India. Another young lady, Kavita Maharaj, attended the Summer Academy of Actuarial and Mathematical Sciences at Morgan State University in the US, gaining valuable insights into the Actuarial Science program. Yet another clear example of our girls having a vision and having the courage to pursue it. Our girls understand the importance of balance, so they play hard, but they also study hard. Some may say that they in fact study harder. The academic results of the CXC examinations on page 4 of your program seem to support this. At the CSEC level, 61 of our girls achieved more than 7 grade ones, with 7 of them achieving 10. There were 14 subjects with a 100% pass rate, with the other 8 subjects over 90%. At the CAPE level, there are 24 of our students with 7 or more grade ones over the 2-year period of CAPE study. There were 18 out of 22 subjects with a 100% pass rate in each unit. One young lady, Keshma Rampasad, our deputy head girl 2023-2024, attained 12 grade ones over the 2-year period. I think that deserves a round of applause. Keshma also received the President's Medal for CSEC 2022. Congratulations must be extended to all of our students and their parents on these excellent results. The staff at Naparima Girls High School continues to extend themselves in the interests of our students. I dare say they are second to none and go above and beyond to ensure that our girls are well provided for academically, socially, emotionally, spiritually, and physically. To the teachers and staff, thank you for your dedication, passion, and commitment to nurturing and guiding these young minds. Your impact on their lives is immeasurable, and we are grateful for all that you do to ensure that we produce graduates who are responsible, well-adjusted individuals committed to excellence and who will contribute positively to a dynamic society. I invite these men and women of our staff to stand as we show our appreciation for their continued dedication and commitment to Naparima Girls High School. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. It is fitting at this point that I maintain our tradition of recognizing members of staff for their years of dedicated service. I invite the Right Reverend Daniel Chance, moderator of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago, to make the following presentation. For 15 years service, Mrs. Lindian Bechu Ramsu. Mrs. Aliyah Marta Caesar. Mr. Ricky Narain. Miss Rachel Rampasad. For 20 years service, Mrs. Beverly Hines George. Thank you, moderator. I invite Dr. Peter Smith, Chief Education Officer, to make the following presentations. For 25 years service, Mrs. Sasha Lal Sabrati. Mrs. Trisha Ramlochan Prasad. For 30 years service, Mrs. Suzanne Rupnarayan Singh. For 35 years service, the celebrity in our midst, our very own Hummingbird Medal. So I'll just finish it right. Our very own Hummingbird Medal, silver recipient in the field of education, Mrs. Naomi Adonis. Thank you, Dr. Smith. We also congratulate Mrs. Simone Babulal on the completion of the Diploma in Education program and the attainment of her professional qualification. During the year, we pause to acknowledge the presence of Dr. the Honorable Nyan Gatsby Dolly, Minister of Education. During the year 2023 to 2024, Mrs. Kathy Ann Sedeno Cook, one of our senior members of staff, opted for early retirement after 36 and a half years service, of which 28 and a half were spent at Naparima Girls High School. We thank her for her years of meritorious service to Naparima Girls and wish her well in this new phase of her life's journey. Upon her retirement, we welcomed Ms. Daniela Joseph. Additionally, music teacher Mr. Sean Sadafal transferred to Hillview College, and we welcomed Mr. Timothy Bali as a volunteer in his place, and subsequently Mrs. Tony Williams-Bess as a T3 music teacher. This year also saw the retirement of Mrs. Leah Gonzalez-Sampa, a member of our office staff. We wish Mrs. Sampath a happy retirement. We welcomed Mrs. Sophia Lachan-Achaiba, Library Assistant 1, past student Ms. Melanie Mohammed as a volunteer counselor, and Mr. Tyrone Batiste, a groundsman, to our staff. Sadly, we lost one of our former members of staff in the last year, former Vice Principal Mrs. Mona Jamadar. Please stand as we honor her memory with 1 minute's silence. May her soul rest in peace. Thank you. Please be seated. Naparima Girls High School owes much of her success to the support she receives from the stakeholders and wider community. I take this opportunity to thank the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago, moderator, the Right Reverend Daniel Chance, school chaplain, Reverend Litra Jacob, chairman of the Presbyterian Secondary Schools Board of Education, Mr. Roy Amrong, and all other members of the board, chairman of the administrative committee, Mrs. Indra Devi Singh, and all other members of the ADCOM, and school manager, Mr. Kenny Arjun, for the support, spiritual guidance, and pastoral care they so willingly provided to us over the year. Our teachers benefited from the Values for Life workshop, as well as the Presbyterian Secondary Schools Board of Education's biennial teachers convention. Many teachers also benefited from the various other workshops organized by the Secondary Schools Board of Education, all aimed at their continuous professional development. Appreciation must also be extended to the local board of the Susamachar Presbyterian Church for always so willingly allowing us the use of the sanctuary and other facilities for our prefect installation, Christmas and Easter services, as well as our school leaving and speech day ceremonies, and more recently as an emergency shelter. The Ministry of Education, through our school supervisors, three, also provided much needed support and guidance. We are always grateful for the interventions of the Supervision and Student Support Services Department of the Victoria Education District, and by extension, the other offices of the Ministry of Education. I take this opportunity to express my absolute delight that the Honorable Minister of Education accepted our invitation to join us once again today. Madam Minister, thank you. I pause also to welcome His Worship, the Mayor of the City of San Fernando, Councillor Robert Paris. The Parents Action Committee plays a vital role in the support and development of our school, and for this we are deeply appreciative. During the academic year 2023-2024, they ran yet another successful golf tournament and assisted the school in a major way with our fundraisers. They also ensured that there was adequate security during the day and generously provided advice on all infrastructural issues. Those of you who would have visited the school since the beginning of this academic year would have been greeted by the beautiful landscaping of the grounds. For this, we extend a special word of gratitude to the PAC. We are thankful that this group continues to exercise its initiative in helping us to provide a wholesome environment in which our girls can thrive. To all of our parents and guardians, thank you for your unwavering support and for entrusting us with the education and growth of your children. Your encouragement and belief in their potential have been instrumental in their success. Girls, join us in acknowledging your parents with a lusty round of applause. The Naparima Girls High School Alumni Association has continued to be a source of support for all our activities. They also readily contribute to our Students' Aid Fund, and for this we cannot thank them enough. This year, they embarked on restarting the mentorship program, which gave our lower six students an opportunity to spend a day with a professional in their intended career field. This was well received by our girls, and we look forward to a bigger and more exciting program next year. Naparima Girls is blessed to be situated in a city that has allowed us to grow and realize our potential. Thanks must therefore be extended to the wider community of San Fernando that has willingly supported our many ventures. The present mayor, Councillor Robert Parris, has assured us that we have his support during his tenure, as is evident by his presence today. Thank you, Councillor Parris. As Naparima Girls High School continues to grow and evolve, even after 112 years, we look forward to the support of our stakeholders in our upcoming projects. You may have noted that some of the music today sounds familiar, especially if you're a fan of Disney classics. This is but a taste of what we have in store for you next January, as Naparima Girls High School presents the musical Beauty and the Beast. Following closely behind will be plans for an upgraded and modernized gymnasium. Stay tuned. Ladies of the graduating class, you have been privileged to be a member of an institution such as Naparima Girls High School for the past 5, 7, or 2 years. An institution that is steeped in tradition, but which embraces the latest trends in education and technology. An institution that provides countless opportunities, both in and out of the classroom, designed to see you blossom into young women ready to face the next stage in your lives. As you move forward, remember that the education you have received here is not just a collection of facts and figures, but a set of tools to help you navigate the complexities of life. Embrace the lessons learned, not just in the classroom, but in every experience, every setback, and every success. These are the building blocks of your character, resilience, and wisdom. And so, dear girls, I end as I started. I encourage you to dream big, to have a clear vision of what your goals are. Make a plan. Be courageous and curious enough to approach the future and pursue your dreams relentlessly. Whether you are continuing your education, entering the workforce, traveling the world, or exploring new ventures, carry with you the values and principles that have been instilled in you during your time here. Be passionate, but also be kind and compassionate in your pursuit of excellence. And in much the same way that the Canadian missionaries must have relied on scripture during those uncertain early days, I remind you to remember the verse from Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Remember, the journey does not end here. Graduation is not the finish line, but a stepping stone to even greater achievements. Go then, my girls, as youth undaunted, pushing those boundaries, whilst remaining lifelong learners, never losing sight of your goals. The world is waiting for the unique contributions that only you can make. I thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Bally, for such a comprehensive report on the past academic year. As a school known for excellence in all areas, we take pride in showcasing our students' talents, both on and off the stage. We are thrilled to introduce the Naparima Girls High School Dance Club, who will be performing a piece titled Simple Belle, Congo Belle, choreographed by our very talented dance teacher, Mrs. Beverly Hines-George. Please join me in welcoming them.
Thank you, Mrs. Hines-George, and all members of the Naparima Girls High School Dance Club for your outstanding performance, showcasing such smooth technique and musicality. There is no denying that the academic excellence demonstrated by our students warrants recognition and commendation through these awards. I would like to invite Ms. Gerada Ramcharan Singh and Mrs. Nadira Sicharan to present the following awards.
Good morning. The following students will receive Naparima Girls High School Awards, the highest standing in each subject. I now invite Reverend Jacob, our school chaplain, to assist with the distribution of these awards. Dance, Zoya Marie Andre. French and Library Studies, Samara Basdev Singh. Library Studies, English Literature, Physical Education, Social Studies History and Technology Education, Ada Mohammed. Technology Education, Information and Communication Technology, Spanish, Casey Simonga. Music, Sarum Budram. Drama, Manyatha Panya. Geography, Integrated Science, Mathematics and Visual Arts, Vanya Ramasa. English Language, Deandra Sugrim. Thank you for once. You may now sit. And thank you, Reverend J.K. Form 2. I now invite Mrs. Beverly Mohan, President of the NGHS Alumni Association, to assist with the distribution of these awards. Music and Technology Education, Sajida Askarali. Music, Caitlin Richards. English Language, Karina Bhagwandas. English Language, Kylie Chanan Singh. Physical Education, Ashlyn Deonorine. Dance, Tajay Johnson. French, Information and Communication Technology, Integrated Science, Spanish, and Visual Arts, Raquel Leng. French, Shala Rajnath. Integrated Science, Shireen Mohammed. Geography, Yesa Marie Lawrence. Drama and English Literature, Vasudha Maraj. Mathematics, Saheli Maharaj. Social Studies, History, Isabel O'Reilly. Thank you, Mrs. Mohan. Thank you, Form 2s.
Good morning. It is my pleasure to invite His Worship the Mayor, Councillor Robert Paris, to assist with the distribution of the following prizes for Form 3. English Literature, Sydney Ascarelli. Spanish, Vandana Babal. Biology, Chemistry, Food and Nutrition, and Physics, Amiya Budusing. Technology Education, Kelly Chantak. Information and Communication Technology, Suri Dori. Geography, Saisha Dilchan. French, Sierra Jagmohan. Social Studies, History, Vanessa Mudu. Music, Gianna Ramblam. Dance, Ileana Wallace. Drama and Dance, Surya Ramnath. Physical Education, Kristen Ramsaran. English Language, Alexis Rock. Mathematics, Haley Sanka. Visual Arts, Rishana Sinanar. Thank you, Your Worship. Thank you, Form 3. The following students will receive trophies sponsored by Pennywise Cosmetics Limited for the highest standing in each subject. It is my pleasure to invite Mrs. Indra Devi Singh, Chairman of the NGHS Administrative Committee, to assist with the distribution of the following trophies. Form 4. English Language, English Literature, and Mathematics, Hannah Ascarelli. Mathematics and Geography, Seychelles Judah. Spanish, Suvieva Bisesa. Principals of Accounts, Anjana Dan. Additional Mathematics, Biology, Chemistry, Information Technology, Physics, and Visual Arts, Mercedes David. Technical Drawing, Vandana Dwarka. Food and Nutrition, Anushka Gangu. Physical Education, Divyanka John Budu. Theatre Arts Drama, Mackenzie Rees-Mahir. Theatre Arts Drama, Alyssa Mohammed. French, Amara Mohammed. Economics, Selena Ramkisun. Principles of Business, Aradhana Ramnarayan Singh. Theatre Arts Dance, Chloe Rampasad. History, Karishma Sanka Singh. Music, Miriam Tangha. Thank you, Mrs. Devi Singh, and thank you, Form 4.
Ms. Ramcharan Singh and Mrs. Icharan. Naparima Girls High School has always shared a solid relationship with the city of San Fernando. Under the leadership of our former mayor, Mr. Junior Igrelu, our partnership has grown stronger, and we are pleased that this bond has continued with His Worship the Mayor Councillor, Mr. Robert Paris. It is my pleasure to welcome His Worship the Mayor Councillor, Mr. Robert Paris, who has remained a friend to our school and a pillar of our community. Please join me in warmly welcoming the Mayor of San Fernando.
May I acknowledge the principal acting, Ms. Karen Bali. May also acknowledge my colleagues, Minister of Education, Ms. Nyan Gatsby-Dolly, the Member of Parliament for San Fernando West, Honorable Faris Awari, and the Member of Parliament for San Fernando East, the Honorable Brian Manning. let me acknowledge and say that this school is really a pillar in the city of San Fernando. I have two relatives who went to Naparima Gills High School. For some reason, both of them are attorneys at law. Maybe that is something that is embedded within the Naparima DNA. But anytime I am asked to speak at these type of events, I'm always delighted, and I always present my fraternal pledge to young people, which goes, anything worth having and worth holding is never easily obtained. The satisfaction felt when goals have been achieved are one of the most dynamic emotions one can experience. These emotions will stimulate you to pursue greater conquests. But the most important thing about a goal are the steps taken to accomplish that goal. Cherish each step. Listen to this one. Many try, but few succeed. What I saw here when it is like was afforded the opportunity to give awards to the Form 2s, I believe it was. I can understand why Naparima Gills continues to be successful, because I jokingly told Mr. Manning, imagine they're giving awards, but they're giving them books. But you know something, that is something my mother would really acknowledge, because growing up, I think that was one of the main gifts that I always used to get for my birthday and Christmas. Kind of was upset, but I understand why. That investment paid off. Naparima Gills continue to shine. The city celebrates 36 years, and we could not be the capital of education and culture had it not been for an institution like Naparima Gills College. And I acknowledge what the head Gill said, that my predecessor was very much embedded in the success of not just Naparima Gills College, but all the schools. Naparima Gills High School. Forgive me. And you know something? You remind me of my sister and my cousin. They would buff me if I made that mistake as well. Naparima Gills High School, you all have really done so much. I'm certain alumni or teachers, thank you for the buff. But it is correct that Mr. Regrello did put a lot into the schools in San Fernando. And I do intend to continue in that vein, because at the end of the day, the best investment that we as leaders of this city can do is to invest into our young people. So we can remember, I'm sure Faris and Brian can remember San Fernando the way we remembered it, when we were able to run up and down the promenade. And all the schools converged on the promenade. For some reason, things aren't the way they used to be. But I'm certain that we are committed to work for the betterment of San Fernando and all of you. Because things have to go back to the way we know it as San Fernandians. As I stated before, 36 years next month. And I invite you to be a part of our celebration. It will be something to remember. And we couldn't celebrate without, sir, how are you? Acknowledge you. We could not celebrate without the schools in San Fernando. So I acknowledge all the schools. and we invite you to participate in our activities. So, ladies and gentlemen, with those few words and the buff that I received, I do have the business of the city to attend to at this time, and I want to once again thank you for the opportunity to speak at this auspicious occasion. Thank you sincerely.
In order to acknowledge the diligence and perseverance displayed by these students in successfully completing the CAPE and CSEC examinations, I welcome the deans of Form 5 and 6, Mrs. Sarah Balgobin and Mrs. Marissa Palaya, to award these girls their CSEC and CAPE awards.
Our CSEC graduates 2024. Certificates are awarded to students who have completed the Caribbean Examinations Council CSEC level examinations. All students who have gained 7 or more distinctions indicated by the asterisk are awarded medals courtesy Laxmi Jewelers Limited. 5A. Samantha Acosta. Mrs. Woodsley will present these certificates to these graduates. Tiffany Ajoda. Sahara Ali. Ria Guru Singh. Ashlyn Ridgelow. Maya Callender. Kaelin Dipchan. Zara Ghani. Adila Hanke. Abhilasha Jaichan, Ariane John, Samara Karim, Kaylee Miraj, Melina Mathura, Amina Mohammed, Jade Najir, Alka Basad, Shamaya Fernandez, Sophia Raghavar, Amber Raghu, Anastasia Ramdas, Sydney Ramkisoon, Arena Ramsumer, Samira Ramsumer, Sydney Suku, Abriana Tin. Thank you, 5M, 5G. Woodsley, Acting Vice Principal, for continuing to assist us with these presentations. Jada Arazi, Emily Atwari, Samira Bash, Charles, Shamaya Charles, Faith Crawford, Crystal Lee. Sierra Gopal, Ravina Harnarak. Chelsea Jairam. Maya Khan. Sophia Khan. Ruth Mahis. Aro McQuan. Farah Mohammed. Ariana Nanan. Nishtha Prasad Singh. Charlotte Rakau. Haley Rahman. Ejiana Ramadan. Avani Ramloka. Erin Ramnarayan is here. Kaylee Richards. Avari Rupnarayan. Krishal Singh. Isabella Tangfu. Ajita Wanke. Thank you, 5G. 5G. Surya Balmavin. J.L. Balwant. Brianna Bernard. Nicole Bernard. Celine Darsu. Lea Devanarayan. Liana Dial. Nika Hassan. Celia Hassanali. Kaya Hopkinson. Mariah Khan. Sayan Lakhan. Isabel Lee Singh. Kaylee Begu. Amara Mohammed. Ariane Mohammed. Ariana Narayan, Sarah Pompey. Anaya Ragbir. Salma Rahman Ali. Carrie-Anne Ramdath. Brianna Ramnarayan.
Shania Rampasad. Anjali Singh. Karina Singh. Alyssa Sonu. Siri Badlamudi. We invite her parent, Dr. Badlamudi, to collect. Naomi Wilson. Thank you, 5H, 5S. Anaira Bihari. Christine Bihari. Vishala Budla. Jada Danasar. Kaelin Dyke. Taya Ford, Casey Huggins, Vinaya Indar Singh, Gabrielle Jagnana, Kira Kunjbihari, Lee Lima, Madison Mari, Isha Manu, Zara Mohammed, Ambika Prasad, Renee Ragveer, Shania Ragunana. Avari Ramarose, Imani Ramdi, Larissa Rampat, Chelsea Rampasad, Sadie Ramsaram, Kaylee Sicharam, Surya Sukhdev, Megan Sukhu, Zaria Surajwali, Daniela Younglock, thank you, Mrs. Woodsley, Acting Vice Principal Naparima Girls, for assisting with the presentation. Thank you, Father.
Good morning. Certificates are awarded to students who have gained two or more subjects at the 2023 and 2024 Caribbean Examinations Council CAPE level examinations. I wish to invite our principal, Mrs. Karen Bali, to aid in the distribution of these certificates. In the event that we do have parent representatives, please come forward when your daughter's name is called so you can collect her certificate in her place. Upper 6A. Cherise Alibokas, Chelsea Baldew, Maya Banham. Sarah Barrett, Amanda Bob, Adita Dore, Haley Gayadine, Delia Gopal, Amrita Hussein, Liana Jeremiah, Amisha Jurai, Caitlin Lukfong, Ariel Mirage, Anika Marshall. Samara Matura, Aliyah Mohammed, Sienna Mohammed, Bridget Mutu, Kirsten Marie Muridali, Alana Passad, Destiny Kwashi. Aliyah Rahaman, Haley Ramcharan, Ariella Ramjohn, Keshma Rampasad. Sidhi Ramsarup, Nichelle Rennie, Lakaya Samuel, Raylene Siram, Sajal Singh. Mika Stroud, Aunt Janine. Sorry, Mika's mommy is here. Janine Thomas. Thank you, Upper 6A, Upper 6B. Marialis Babula. Vandana Balkaran. Vida Bansi Singh, Moreno Bihari. Sarissa Barrett, Kyra Briggs, Haley Daniel. Amala Durgadeen, Cadence Gokul, Ranilla Gunnis, Chloe Jacob, Shavara Jagru, Priyanka Kelawan, Alexis Lomu. Naya Miraj, Asina Martin. Natalia McBurney, Aziza Mohammed, Leah Mohammed Shah, Dine Mutusing. Katrina Murphy, Aurora Rackard. Ashley Ramdas, Renetta Ramlakan, Celeste Ramsing. I believe Ashley's mommy is coming to collect her certificate. Ashara Satahu, Ariel Sunarai. Ishana Talma and Danielle, Destiny Young Love, sorry, Destiny. And Destiny's mom is here to collect her certificate. Thank you, Upper 6B, Upper 6C. Lexi Balchan, Andel Balwa. Nishka Basdeo, Shania Bihari, Caitlin Beam, Emily Bairaji, Felice Das, Jade Fuentes, Justine Gooding, Trishana Ginas, Kirsten John, Alexa Leonard, Ravishta Lakshman. Caitlin Manmohan. Caitlin's mommy is coming to collect her certificate. Caitlin Martin, Jada Musa. Isabel Mohammed, Madison Mohammed, Mary Beth Nagasa, and Visa Panya. Chelsea Puran Rudal, Shivani Raghunanan, Haley Ramparose, Ariana Ramhit, Ariel Ramuta, Nalini Ramratan, Sahara Ramsume, Khatija Ross, oh, Sahara's mommy. Khatija Ross. Chloe Sicharan, Amelia Sudas, and Jinky Song. Thank you, Upper 6C, and thank you, Mrs. Barrett.
Thank you, Mrs. Balgobin and Ms. Palaya. As we celebrate our students today, it's essential to recognize their accomplishments achieved through hard work and dedication. CSEC and CAPE awards will now be distributed, and I wish to invite Ms. Shari Bastio, Mrs. Alana Sukchan, and Ms. Roxanne Haripal Singh to assist in the presentation of these awards.
Good morning. The following students will receive awards for the highest standing, grade 1, in each subject in the Caribbean Examinations Council CSEC 2024 examinations. I now invite our school manager, Mr. Kenny Arjun, to distribute these awards. The Gangadeh Jatin Singh Award for English Language, the Farah Muhammad Award for Music, and the Keith Kang's Books, etc. Award for Physical Education and Sports, Jada Arazi. The Imogen Foster Algu Award for English Literature, Samira Baksh. The Bill and Sharon Ramratan Award for Integrated Science, Brianna Bernard. The NGHS Prize for Chemistry and the Hollis Duncan Memorial Award for Economics, Rianne Budusing. Thank you. the Signature Stationery Business Works Limited Award for Caribbean History, Shamaya Charles. The Rian Nayan Memorial Award for Visual Arts, Kaylin Dipchan. The Nadine Ramharak Award for Food, Nutrition and Health, Gabrielle Jagnanath. The Kisurlal and Nanki Samlal Memorial Award for Principals of Accounts, Anaya Raghver. The Dr. Trudy Kewal Award for Spanish, Anastasia Ramdas. The Hardy's Chartered Accountants Award for Principals of Business, Sydney Rampisu. The Irie Theatre Productions Limited Award for Theatre Arts, Narisa Rampa. The Razia Idu Memorial Award for Additional Mathematics, Ivari Rupnarain. The J.T. Alum and Company Limited Award for English Literature, Alyssa Sunu. The Razia Idu Memorial Award for Additional Mathematics, the Gopal's Toy and Baby Store Award for Biology, the Dr. Lisa Kim Sahai Prize for Chemistry, the J.T. Alum and Company Limited Award for English Literature, the Sarah Jacob Award for French, the Lina Talakdari Award for Geography, the Ruklal Family Award for Information Technology, the Lakshmi Patel Award for Mathematics, and the Dr. Meera Gopal Award for Physics, Siri. The Knapp Sisters Book Club 1988-1990 Award for Literature and the Lakshmi Singh Family Award for Technical Drawing, Daniela Youngla. Thank you, Mr. Arjun, and thank you, Form 5s.
The following students will receive awards for the highest standing, Grade 1, in each subject in the Caribbean Examinations Council, CAPE 2024 examinations. I would like to invite the Honorable Brian Manning, Minister in the Ministry of Finance and Member of Parliament for San Fernando East, to assist in the distribution of these awards. The Kavita Nalisha and Shivani Ramroop Award for Physical Education and Sport, Kaylin Arjun. The Dorothy and the late Lorna Kalinda Award for Applied Mathematics and the Steve Baldeusing Award for Physics, Maya Balwa. The Rudranan and Avisha Maharaj Award for Economics, Haley Bisnak. The HV Holdings Limited Award for Entrepreneurship, Krishan Guru Singh. Roxanne Ishmael Harnarayan Award for Communication Studies, Nivedita Bridgelal. The Rahamat Enterprises Limited Trophy for Information Technology, Ivana Devi. The Ramjit Family Award for French, Adriana Diokaran. The Mrs. Cintra Lucky Award for History, Jada Danraj. The Sherry Raghubar Tulsi Award for Spanish, Rian Hiralal. The Dr. Sastri Harinarayan Award for Management of Business, Naomi Jairam. The Island-Wide Pest Services Award for Entrepreneurship, Amaya John Budu. The Dr. Afraz and Mrs. Nadia Ali Award for Computer Science, Kaylee Kisoon. The Rory Alaha Memorial Award for Sociology, Sarah Maharaj. The Nadine Sipasad Hackett Award for Accounting, Inaya Omardine. The Gulf Engineering Award for Geography, Dana Ramcharan. The Charmaine Rahman Susanka Award for Art and Design, Sharon Richardson. The JT Alum and Company Limited Award for Communication Studies, Samir Rojan. The Stuart and Minty Ishmael Memorial Award for Biology, the Shivyana P.S. Mahabir Award for Chemistry, and the Dr. Sitara Bajan Award for Pure Mathematics, Elizabeth Singh. The Alan Gopal Singh Family Award for Performing Arts, Zion Taylor. Thank you, Mr. Manning.
I would like to invite our upper sixth students receiving awards and also invite the Honorable Faris Al Rawi, Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government and Member of Parliament for San Fernando West. The RPL 1991 Limited Award for Sociology, Vandana Balkaran. The Ria Jahu Memorial Award Applying Mathematics, the Dr. Karen Rahman Memorial Award for Chemistry, the Harinarayan Orthodontics Limited Challenge Trophy for Physics, and the Dr. Dolly Harsharan Memorial Award for Pure Mathematics, Anil Balwa.
Thank you.
Harunaran Memorial Award for Performing Arts, Dance, Jade Fuentes. The Dr. Constance Wagle Memorial Award for Art and Design, Cadence Bogu. The GOPCO Oilfield and Industrial Supplies Limited Award for Entrepreneurship, Alexis Long. The Keith Cairns Book Etc. Award for Performing Arts Music, Ravishta Lajman. The Chessman Family Award for Caribbean Studies, Jada Musa. The Lalita Limited Award for Physical Education and Sport, Danae Mutusing. The Dr. and Mrs. C.S. Puran Singh Award for Biology, Anvita Panya. The Imogen Foster Albu Award for Information Technology, Aurora Rathel. The Gopal Lands Hardware Award for Computer Science, Keshwa Ramasan. The Lurton Patterson Award for Spanish, Celeste Ramsing. The Gulf Engineering Award for Geography, Sahara Ramsmere. The JT Alum and Company Limited Award for French and the Keith Cairns Book Etc. Award for Performing Arts Drama, Khatija Ross. I thank you, the Honorable Faris Arari, for helping us with our presentation.
Thank you, Ms. Basdeo, Mrs. Sukchan, and Ms. Haripal Singh. It brings me great honor to welcome the moderator of the Synod of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago, the Right Reverend Daniel Chance. Reverend Chance is an eloquent speaker who challenges all believers to pledge, commit, and be dedicated to God's hand and purpose for his church and their lives. Please welcome the Right Reverend Daniel Chance as he extends greetings on behalf of the Presbyterian Church.
All protocols have been acknowledged. Naparima Girls High School continues to be one of the most sought after secondary schools in the country. No doubt, it is as a result of the reputation in academic excellence, as well as the holistic development of every child. Students, graduating class, through your achievements, continue to fly the flag of this noble institution. This was the vision of the pioneers, the founding mothers and fathers who established this school, as Miss Karen Bali said, I call her Miss all the time, 112 years ago. For those of us who are familiar with the Bible, in Proverbs 29 and verse 18, we read, where there is no vision, what happens? Yes, the people perish. The God who created us did so with a vision. God places value on every life. God has given to us His Spirit. And students, parents, teachers, God's Spirit dwells within us. And this Spirit will help you as students. This Spirit would help all of us to grow and become God's people, our brothers and our sisters' keepers. Students, developing a vision for your life will help you to stay focused on your goals. I am sure, and our parents and teachers can verify, girls, many years ago, while you were in primary school, you envisioned attending Naparima Girls High School. Is that so? Yes. And this vision has been realized, meaning that you are here. For some of you, your vision will move you onto studies such as CAPE, while some have already started tertiary education. While you continue to climb the academic ladder, it is important for you to remain grounded or connected to the teachings and values which you have gleaned over the years. I beg you, the graduating class of 2024, to remember your parents and grandparents. Where I am these days, right on Naparima College compound, next to the compound, I have seen parents and grandparents, Mr. Junior one, who would come 1 o'clock with hot food for their children and grandchildren. Students, only your parents and grandparents can love you unconditionally. I repeat, only your parents and grandparents can love you unconditionally. They pray for you every day. They continue to intercede on your behalf. Our teachers, our principal, our vice principal, Students, do not forget those who have shaped your life and influenced your thinking. Yesterday I said at another place, parents, grandparents, and teachers are scholarship winners. Ms. Bali?
Correct? Yes.
Do not forget those, I'm repeating. Do not forget those who have shaped your life and influenced your thinking. Where do you go from here? Meaning at Cape or at tertiary studies or the world of work. The knowledge you have acquired must be used to empower others. Students, as you have been blessed, go out into the world and be a blessing to others. On behalf of the Synod of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago, I bring you greetings on this occasion of your graduation. Blessings to all.
Thank you, moderator, for your uplifting greetings and for being a great example of living a life of faith. It is undeniable that we recognize that excellence goes beyond academics, as our institution displays a melting pot of diverse skills and talents across various fields, all of which pour into cultivating holistically developed individuals. I would like to call upon Mrs. Lindianne Betu Ramsuk and Mrs. Tricha Ramlocham Prasad to present the special awards.
The following students will be presented with special awards. However, many of the awardees are at university, at home or abroad, and will not be here today. If any family member is present, please feel free to come and collect the award on their behalf. I would now like to warmly invite School Supervisor 3, Mr. Sheldon Judah, to assist in the distribution of the following awards. The Class of 1984 Award for Excellence in Drama in honor of the late Mrs. Mavis Liwa, Jada Arazi. The Class of 1984 Award for Excellence in Drama in honor of the late Mrs. Mavis Liwa, Katisha Ross. The Signature Stationery Business Works Limited Award for Music, Kira Balwa. The Simons Musical Supplies Award for Music, Chelsea Hanumanta. Sydney Mohan Award for Promising Vocalist, Zion Taylor. The RIK Award for Outstanding Contribution to Choir, Janice Pierre. The Sue and Neera Rambajan Award for Dance, Jade Fuentes. The Dr. Michelle Heidel Memorial Award for Art at Form 5, Anjali Singh. The Dr. Michel Haidal Memorial Award for Art in Upper Six, Nishka Basdev. The Mona Chamada Prize for Creative Writing, Siri Valdemudi. Thank you, Mr. Joda, for your kind assistance. I would now like to invite Acting Principal Mrs. Karen Bali to assist in the distribution of the following awards. The Grace and Dr. Genevieve Parker Prize for Literary Excellence, Celeste Ramsey. The Captured Moments TT Award for Excellence in Sport Table Tennis, Priyanka Kilawan. The Justice Gillian Award for Creative Writing, Yasee Marie Lawrence. The Honorary Family Award for Excellence in Sport Badminton, Kaylee Rajkumar. The Mangal Singh Family Award for Excellence in Sport Badminton, Samia Karim. The Jansker Technologies Limited Award for Excellence in Sport Badminton, Isabel Waller. The Lalita Mirage Award for Excellence in Sport Swimming, Isabella Mendoza. The Southern Botec Archery Club Award for Excellence in Sport Archery, Mariah Khan. The NJHS Award for Excellence in Sport Archery, Kaylin Arju. The RPL 1991 Limited Award for Excellence in Chess, Aradhana Ramnarayan Singh. Thank you, Mrs. Bali, and congratulations once again to all our students.
I now invite the chairman of the Presbyterian Secondary Schools Board of Education, Mr. Roy Umrao, to assist in the distribution of these special awards. The Nadia Birju Memorial Award for Most Outstanding Library Prefect, Vida Bansi Singh. The NGHS Alumni Association Award for Promising Form 5 Student, Madison Madu. The Indar Tilkaran Award for Promising Form 5 Student, Sarah Pompey. The Sunny Moon Tantu Memorial Award for Promising Form 5 Student, Tiffany Ajoda. The Rita Rahman Memorial Award for Promising Form 5 Student, Ravina Harnarain. The the Alexi Anavari Ramaruz Award for Most Promise, for Most Progress in Form 5, Prashel Singh. The Susan Gopi Singh Award for Determination in Form 5, Madison Madu. The Cecilia Lamoral Memorial Award for Determination in Form 5, Sydney Ramkisoon. The Vashanta Ivana Samlal Prize for Determination in Form 5, Celine Darsu. K.S. Chinpaya Contracting Services Limited Award for Determination in Form 6, Athena Martin. The Gopi Chan Singh Sufal Award for Determination in Form 6, Caitlin Manohan. And Caitlin's mom will collect on her behalf. The Giselle G. Hampton Award for Determination in Form 6, Janine Thomas. The Betty Ramdas Prize for Determination in Form 6, Ashley Ramdas. And Ashley's mom, Neil Collector, on behalf. The Avisha and Manisha Patel Award for Determination in Form 6, Emily Bairagi. The McDonnell Mitchell Memorial Prize for Determination in Form 6, Liana Jeremiah. Thank you, Mr. Umrah. I now invite the moderator of the Synod of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago, the Right Reverend Daniel Chance, to assist in the distribution of these special awards. The Aldred Langine Adonis Bursary for Outstanding All-Round Form 6 Student, Khatija Ross. The Giselle G. Hampton Book Grant, Mika Stroud. And Mika's mom will collect on her behalf. The Doris Sog Hagen Tanku Award for Promising Form 6 Student, Leah Mohammed Shah. The Indira Tilkaran Award for Promising Form 6 Student, Ashley Ramdas. And Ashley's mom will come to collect on her behalf. The Parents Action Committee Bursary, Anika Marshall. The Nu Gamma Mu Sigma Olympiad Prize for Junior Level, Vandana Baba. The Kavita Babal Olympiad Award for Senior Level, Alina Ragba. The Minty Ramkisoon Ishmael Memorial Trophy for Most Outstanding House, Cavell. In the absence of the previous House Captain and Deputy House Captain, Ms. Tanku Mahare will collect on their behalf. The Sharon Sahadev Award for the Most Outstanding French and a Spanish Student in Form 3, Vandana Babal. The Mrs. Aliyah Rita Rahman Award for the Most All-Round Student in Form 3, Ariel Valentine. The Sharon Ramdas Award for the Most Promising Computer Science Student in Lower 6, Anaya Manu. The Edo Trophy for Master Chemist 2024, Sianna Mohammed. Thank you, Moderator Chance.
Thank you, Mrs. Bechu Ramsuk and Mrs. Ramlochan Prasad. I just want to take a moment and ask, did anyone notice our incredible music students and teachers on the steel pan when these awards were being distributed? I think they definitely elevated the overall experience. A performance in song is certainly one way to render a smile on anyone's face. Let us put our hands together for the renowned Naparima Girls High School Senior Choir, trained under the tremendous trio of Mrs. Edwards Paul, Mr. Bali, and Mrs. Williams Bess, as they delight us with a rendition of Kirk Franklin's Smile.
There is no sunshine, nothing but clouds and stars.
Is it any surprise that we won 6 championship trophies at Music Festival earlier this year? Thank you, Senior Choir, for that beautiful and inspiring performance. You all definitely made us smile and are truly a testament to the skill and talent of our school. As we continue to celebrate the outstanding achievements of our students beyond the classroom, I invite Mrs. Vishali Tanku Mahadeu to present the special awards to these well-rounded individuals.
Good morning. As we continue with our special awards, I would like to invite our Minister of Education, the Honorable Dr. Nian Gatsby-Dolly, to assist in the distribution of the following awards. The Wendy Balgobin Memorial Award for Most Outstanding Student at CSEC, Siri Vadlamuni. Vadlamudi is collecting on her behalf. The Dipnarayan and Sheila Rampasad Award for Outstanding Results at CSEC, Jada R. Razi. The Jodine Akyung Award for Excellence at CSEC, Rianne Budusu. The Presbyterian Secondary Schools Board of Education Award for Excellence at CSEC, Daniela Yangla. The Drs. Malini and Kailash Gosain Award for Most Outstanding Natural Science Student at CSEC, Siri Vadlamudi. Presbyterian Secondary Schools Board of Education Award for Excellence at CAPE, Aurora Raka. The Patricia Rambulam Award for Excellence at CAPE, Keshma Rampasad. The Joel and Jean Bahadur Award for Excellence at CAPE, Mika Stroud. And Mika's mommy will collect on her behalf. The Carolyn Bali Gosain Award for Excellence at CAPE, Andel Balwa. The Naparima Girls High School Non-Novice Foundation Award goes to our Peer Helpers. Elizabeth Singh, President of the Peer Helpers, will collect. The Dr. Errol and Yvonne Mahabir Memorial Trophy for Responsibility, Farah Mohammed. The Monica Prayag Memorial Award for Responsibility, Rayan Budusing. The Jayanti Lakshmidyal Award for Responsibility, Surya Balgubik. The Beulah Mehu Memorial Award for Responsibility, Andel Balwa. the Yashoda Suku David Award for Responsibility, Chelsea Puran Rudan. The Antonia Lucky Award for Leadership, Janice Pear. The Janska Technologies Limited Prize for Leadership, Ariana Ramhit. The Fortitude Financial Services Prize for Leadership, Keshma Rampasad. The Chameleon Consulting Limited Award for Cultural Contribution to Naparima Girls High School, Chelsea Hanumanta. The Dolores Lovell Memorial Award for Significant Contribution to the Sporting and Cultural Life of our school, Khadija Ross. The Lynette Maharaj Memorial Award for Contribution to Corporate Life of the School, Keshma Rampasad. The Naparima Girls High School Citizenship Award, Morena Bihari. The Comrade Shafiq Hayatali Award for President's Medal Gold, CSEC 2022, Keshma Rampasad. Thank you very much, Madam Minister.
Thank you, Mrs. Tanku Mahariu. It is my distinct privilege to welcome our esteemed guest and feature speaker, Dr. the Honorable Nian Gatsby-Dolly. Dr. Nian Gatsby-Dolly is the Minister of Education of Trinidad and Tobago and has been a Member of Parliament since 2015. Representing the St. Anne's East constituency, she has a strong educational background, having graduated from the University of the West Indies and has previously worked as an educator at St. Francois Girls College and as a senior lecturer at the College of Science, Technology and Applied Arts of Trinidad and Tobago. As the Minister of Education, Dr. Gatsby-Dolly has been at the forefront of advancing educational initiatives that empower our students. Her dedication to improving her role is evident, and we are honored to have her with us today. Please join me in welcoming the Honorable Dr. Nian Gatsby-Dolly.
A very pleasant good morning to all, and I stand on the protocols that have been already observed. It is a pleasure to be here once again, I believe, Principal. Pleasure to be here once again to celebrate what is a momentous occasion with Naparima Girls High School. Although I've observed the protocols, please allow me to recognize the principal who is visiting here today of the school that I attended, St. Augustine Girls High School. And as I sit here in these awards, it brings back so many memories of my own times at SADS. Trinidad and Tobago is 62 years young. And I'm not going to be very long because we've had a full morning celebrating our students. But I want to leave us just with something to ponder. We are 62 years young. If we compare ourselves to some societies that we like to compare ourselves with, the US is almost 250 years old. Canada, about 160-something years old. We are 62 years young. I want us to think about, most of us may not have been around fully. Some may have been in thoughts. Some may have been young in 1962. when we became a nation. But everyone you speak to, and if you will, a thought at that time, you'd be around 61 or 62 now. And if you were about 10 years old at that time, you'd be about 72 years old now. And everyone you speak to who lived around that time and was aware of what was happening in Trinidad and Tobago can tell you of the immense pride that was felt when that Union Jack came down and our flag went up and we became Trinidad and Tobago. A country that was saying to the world at that time that we could take care of ourselves. And in that time, we have done well for ourselves. We've come a long way. But everyone who was aware at that time would be in their 70s and more. So what they would have instilled in their children based on the pride they had in building this nation, those would be the children who are leading today. They'd be around my age, this young, nice age that I am now. They'd be around that age, 40s, 50s. And this is our time for leadership now. So we have come a full generation into it, where those who would have been around at the start are now past. They have passed on that pride to us, their children. And it is now for us to pass on that fire that must burn in all of our hearts for national development to our children. That's you here. All of these beautiful young ladies that we have awarded and celebrated. You are the ones that it is our responsibility now to pass on that fire for national development to you. Because as we are passing into that stage that our parents are in now, we are preparing the stage for you to take this Trinidad and Tobago that we are all very proud of. So in a few years, all the teachers that we see here would be people of your generation. All of the leaders that you see now will be from your generation. And that is why in Trinidad and Tobago, we are so blessed and privileged to have spent and to invest every year so much in education. Because we want to ensure that as we do our part as leaders today, what we prepare our young people to do is exactly what we are doing, and in some cases, even better. Because what we all want is a progressive Trinidad and Tobago. So that when we reach to 160 years old or 250 years old, we can look back with pride at what we have built and what we have accomplished. So when we recognize the excellence of our young people, when we offer them a holistic education as they have been offered here, I've looked at the prizes, theater arts, music, responsibility, not just the academics. Because we recognize that to develop ourselves into the nation we want to be, it's not just the qualifications and the skills. It's also the positive values, attitudes, and behaviors that will take us there. So I want to congratulate Naparima Girls High School and all of our schools that are working hard to produce our leaders of the future. Because we want to look back many years from now where we will not be. But we want to know that we have contributed to building this nation to the level that we want it to be. We have many natural blessings. Our people are a blessing. Our melting pot is a blessing. People come from all over the world and they are in awe at the fact that we can exist so peaceably, all of us, different backgrounds, different ethnicity, different religions, but existing in peace and harmony. tolerating everyone, and celebrating all. That is a strength in Trinidad and Tobago that we must never overlook or understate. So even as we celebrate the success of our young people, I invite us to do all we can in this time, now we that lead, to ensure we prepare the place for them. And I invite our young people, as I always do, I exhort you to look towards the future of Trinidad and Tobago. Understand why all of this is being invested in you. Because we want you to lead us and to lead us even better, to do a better job than we are doing ourselves. We love this nation and we love our young people. And despite our challenges, we are doing much better than some, but we have much better that we can do. So on behalf of the Ministry of Education, it has been my pleasure to be here and to see the outcome of the hard work of the teachers, of the principal, of the stakeholders of Naparima Girls High School. I note, and I ask the principal about it, I note the pouring into the lives of the students in this school. Awards coming from all over. And the principal indicated that people call to get their award in. And that is an excellent, excellent model. Our chief education officer is seated in the crowd, so I must acknowledge him. As I say to him in our master principal sessions, and Mr. Ajodo, our school supervisor, we need to ensure that we have the principal sharing with other schools how to get some more corporate sponsorship into your school. Because it's important. Education is good business, and it's everyone's business. We have been speaking about cultural transformation through education in our schools. Because at 62 years old, we are kind of at a crossroads. It's a mix of bring back the old time days and never look back, look ahead. We're in the middle there. There are some things that we have lost that we need to regain. But there are some things that are ahead of us that we need to move forward to. And all of Trinidad and Tobago is required to join us in this transformative journey. So as we see what's happening at Naparima High School, what has been happening for years, it's our ideal for all of our students. We speak about equity and educational opportunity. Because we want what's happening here to be replicated everywhere. And there are some schools and some students who don't have the benefit of this type of educational opportunity. And we are hard at work trying to bring that equity so that all of our students can benefit and will be able to develop their truest potential. So thank you for the example you are setting and you have been setting for years. And as we work to encourage all of our schools, we exhort you to consider in the next couple of years the type of leaders you will be and the type of Trinidad and Tobago that you are going to create. Thank you all. May God bless us and may God bless Trinidad and Tobago.
Thank you, Dr. Gatsby Dolly, for honoring us with your presence today and for your words of inspiration, reminding us to keep that fire, that national pride, burning in our hearts so that we too can share it from generation to generation in hopes of achieving a nation that we want to create. On behalf of our principal, vice principal, and the entire school community, we express our gratitude for your continued support. And we look forward to furthering the goals of excellence in education together. We are thankful for the invaluable role that you play in shaping the future of our nation. It has truly been an honor for us to serve as your chairpersons for today's program. We wish to thank all of you, our distinguished guests, students, staff, and all stakeholders for making this event so special. We have celebrated excellence and the hard work of our students, and it's moments like these that remind us of the strength of our school community. As we close, we'd like to leave you with a powerful verse from Isaiah 40, 31. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint.
This verse encourages us all to place our faith in the Lord, reminding us that we are equipped to rise above challenges and achieve greatness. Once again, thank you for being part of this wonderful celebration. Our acting vice principal, Ms. Woodsley, a charismatic, creative, and compassionate Hummingbird Silver Medal awardee, will now lead us in the vote of thanks.
Thank you, girls. When Micaiah was saying thank you there, I was getting worried because I say like the girl will take my walk. Dr. The Honorable Nan Gadsby Dolly, Minister of Education and Member of Parliament for St. Anne's East. The Honorable Faris Alwari, Minister of Rural Development and Local Government and Member of Parliament for San Fernando West. The Honorable Brian Manning, Minister in the Ministry of Finance and Member of Parliament for San Fernando East. The moderator of the Synod of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago, the Right Reverend Daniel Chance. His Worship the Mayor in his absence. Chief Education Officer, Dr. Peter Smith. Deputy Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Education, Mr. Wilson Henderson. School Supervisor 3, Mr. Sheldon Joda, School Chaplain, Reverend Litra Jacob, and all members of the clergy, Chairman of the Presbyterian Secondary Schools Board of Education, Mr. Roy Umral, School Manager, Mr. Kenny Arjun, Chairman of the Naparima Girls High School Administrative Committee, Mrs. Indra Devi Singh, President of the Naparima Girls High School Alumni Association, Mrs. Beverly Mohan, Madam Principal Acting, Mrs. Karen Bali, all specially invited guests, parents, students, and all members of the media. Gratitude has been described as one of the pathways to greater happiness. It nurtures positivity and allows for the building of the maintenance of better relationships. With this in mind, permit me at this time to express gratitude to all who would have contributed to the success of today's event. It is so very easy to overestimate the importance of our own achievements compared with what we owe to the help of others. Madam Minister, we can never overlook the work that you do, and of course that your ministry does in ensuring that schools flourish in this land of Trinidad and Tobago. We thank you for taking time out of your schedule, which we know is very busy, to be with us again. And Naparima Girls High School is blessed. She was here last year. So we thank you, Madam Minister, and invite you, please, to come forward and accept a token of appreciation from all of us here at Naparima Girls. I invite our head girl to assist me. Thank you. We had a gentleman with us last year who spoke and described himself as an honorary NAPS girl. Our staff knows. I invite the Honorable Faris Alwari to please come forward and accept a token from all of us at Naparima. He says he's still an honorary Nap school. Thank you, Scarlett. I invite the Honorable Brian Manning, Minister in the Ministry of Finance and Member of Parliament for San Fernando East, to accept a token, and either our head or deputy head girl will assist us. We are commanded by Scripture to give thanks in all things. And in all things, we give thanks for the role that our church plays in ensuring that Naparima Girls High School continues to flourish. We acknowledge the role of our moderator at this point as we present to him a token of appreciation. Reverend Jones. Gratitude can indeed transform common days like today, which really is not so common, into an event of thanksgiving. Gratitude can turn routine into joy. It can change ordinary opportunities into blessings. And Naparima Girls High School is indeed blessed. We want to thank all our stakeholders. We have representatives of our ADCOM, we have our school supervisor, we have our manager, all right? We have representative of our school board. We have parents who continue to support the work of Naparima Girls High School. We want to thank all of you for sharing in today's event. Girls, give a round of applause to all our specially invited guests. We also must thank our school chaplain, Reverend Litra Jacob, for opening us with a word of prayer. We know that we can call Reverend Jacob at the drop of a hat, not only come to church, but to come to school, to share and bless whatever we do. So we thank Reverend Jacob for starting us on the right foot this morning. Let's thank her. We thank all who assisted in the distribution of prizes and awards. We thank especially our music teachers, one and all. We thank our dance teacher, who was here. I'm not seeing her there anymore. Time George. We thank our dancers and our panists and our choir. Ladies and gentlemen, I invite you now to please stand for our school hymn, followed by our benediction and the exit of the platform party.